flustered by all the people, aren't you? Spent so long in your meetings without people.
Well, it's different to be around normal people. I've been around plenty of soldiers. I've never seen so many 19-year-old privates in my life. 19-year-old privates and 23-year-old lieutenants.
Just trying to ease you into no pressure, right?
We made a video
the other day. We'll roll the chalkboard. Roll the chalkboard. Roll the chalkboard up there. Start scribbling.
We're having technical difficulties. Just trying to get the machine locked on. We should start momentarily. Chair, I'd like to recognize our staff at Wynn Academy. Wynn Academy was recognized last Wednesday by the Minnesota Department of Education as a student school of excellence for PBIS. PBIS stands for Positive Behavior Intervention Supports. Wynn Academy has a pretty robust PBIS recognition program. If you've been over there, Starbucks, it's, you know, of course, Starbucks, so it's kind of funny, but it's, they have a set of points that kids can get being in their cantina for getting positive points. They're recognized by a commissioner webinar, and they made a short little video, which I'll share out. But I want to recognize all our staff and for their list of bills. He pulls out and we through tonight when we discuss the budget, our expenditures at this point is 89% budget to actual. We obviously have one more set of expenditures in fiscal year 20. Now there might be some bills that come in after June 30th, but right now we don't estimate any concerns with our budget to actual for this fiscal year. A copy of the bills are in there. Significant. You're going to see it be significantly shorter. Typically, this time of year, we, Mr. Ellingworth, this board meeting, you'd be approving a bunch of July 1st billings. We have not spent any money in fiscal 21. Because we're kind of waiting to see what, on July 27th, MB is going to make a decision on what next year's going to look like. And what we're trying to do is just not spend a lot of money like we traditionally do for a traditional school year until we get direction. Because there'd be no sense in buying like $9,000 worth of workbooks if we're going to do something different. It wouldn't make a lot of sense to buy as many science supplies if we're not going to be able to physically do labs. We can make all the purchases in August. It shouldn't be a major concern. While we were also kind of holding to figure out what our financials would look like. So that's why you don't see a lot of bills. Thing is, there's no bad news in there, so because we're not really in the stock market, so we have a stable checking interest, savings interest.
Hey, food service update.
If you see a copy in there, the only significant thing, and I don't think I'm gonna make sure Justin can join in.
I did just send him the link.
I'm going to invite him in right now. I promise we did pay that bill. It's just this little. It's usually not this little. Okay. I should get Justin. Board members and for anybody else, when you log in July, you're going to have a new version of Board Book and you'll be sending out some training. So it's going to look different, so it's going to look more like this. But I do believe, Angie, we are on old Board Book still, correct?
Correct.
So
this is our last meeting.
This will be our last meeting on the Classic. Classic is going away. So, Rick, I don't know if you're familiar with Board Book, but everything we kind of run our
Yep, I'm in.
The agenda is just pulling up, Justin, and then.
Okay.
I'll present my screen so you can see where we're at.
Okay. I did my own pledge, so I'm good there. I took a knee, but I did.
Oh. All right. Mr. Chair, there's our investment update. There's our food service report. I think we see in there, we were able to shut down few days early to clean our kitchen, and we haven't made any purchases because the challenge is we're really not sure. So we had a lot of food out of Cisco, but I think we've been credited back, so it's been resolved. So there's not a lot of activity in the food service support. And then next month, you will, on the agenda, as presented, we'll be adding 10 cents for our lunch. Rick, keep up with inflation, so you'll see that in our July work.
Okay. you want to proceed with your report?
Yep, I'll go. Let me just get in here. Our board meetings are usually more lively too, but I feel like I'm playing catch up on technology right now, so. Justin, can you see the September 5th or June 15th board report?
Yeah, I can see it loading.
Okay. So, Mr. Chair, members of the board, this is our board report for June 15th. Enrollment count for May 30th, we ended the year. We actually ended the year the same. So, if you look at our total enrollment, 1257, that does not include that we didn't include our WIN kids, but the total is 1309, and we got paid on 1270 because that difference. Rick, is those that difference of 39, those are not resident kids, those are WIN kids that we get tuition on. So we count those as an enrollment, but we do not get ADMs on them. So it'll be a little misleading at times. This is our, as of last Monday, we were 89% budget to actual. So you'll see that we were over in instructional support services, so that would be in our special ed. And then you'll see we were over on our site building equipment. Obviously, we made some investments in our pool. We had to put on a new boiler in. That wasn't necessarily planned. And then you can see that for our regular instruction, 79%, you can see some of those costs there. But right now, so was we're at 89% of budget actual. I've put in here discussion item number 28. It's going to discuss summer programming. I think I was probably, because I was remoting in trying to come to this board meeting, I think it was Bill, I had to come forward quick. I don't think you're not necessarily going to 28 right now, but I do want to make sure the board, I think the confusion was, is that at our work session, we talked about speed and strength only on the 15th. What we could have said is there could be additional. There is additional programming we're looking at that allows under the State High School League and the Minnesota Department of Health and the National Federation. And if you go to MDH, the Minnesota Department of Health will take you to the D website about community sports or youth sports. There is opportunity to do more, and I want to thank Rick Ellingworth, their conference. Which conference are you in?
Big South.
The Big South Conference came up with some documents for checkout, you know, checklists. And so for everybody watching or coaching staff, we met with our coaches on the 31st, which was graduation, and to develop a plan that had to be, you know, available registration and execution within 2 weeks. It started today. We picked speed and strength just because that was common to boys and girls, and it really wasn't picking one activity over a different activity. So we allowed Laker Legends under the community ed, and we allowed speed and strength. Well, we weren't prepared to do like summer rack because typically we have 100 kids. We really weren't supposed to be inside. You know, what are you doing during inclement weather? How can you hire enough employees to cover 1 to 10? Because we don't normally keep that ratio. And then if you can't do that, then how many do you need to hire? How much do you need to charge? Tonight in the budget that you're going to see, I think community ed fund 4 ended like $40,000 to $60,000 upside down, and that's just because we weren't able to collect tuition. So Bill and I have been working, and these documents will be released to coaches after our discussion tonight, but I want to make sure you saw them. And there is protocol to do more activities, so, you know, if a dance coach wanted to have dance, as long as she goes through the 56 pages of guidance and works through the protocols and develops these procedures and gives them to Bill and meets all the intent, we can make sure that we follow the steps provided to us. I don't have an issue doing that, so I want to make sure you knew all these documents, where they're at, all the guidance. It's just that when we met on that Friday the 31st, we were not ready to do this in 2 weeks. And I also was in a regional superintendent meeting with Region 6A, which is probably as north as Perham. I mean, you're in 6A. I think we're about as south as it gets. I don't know. How far east is it going?
We're about as far south or east.
Okay. But it goes all the way, not more as too big, but I saw DGF there, so right up to Moorhead. Two-thirds of the school districts weren't going to do anything starting today. They were going to wait until July 6th. And up to that point, multiple meetings, Bill, was July 6th. So now everybody's like, oh my gosh, what are we gonna do in 2 weeks to open everything up? The other issue is you have a lot of conflicting guidance, right? You can be in groups of 25, but you can't be in groups of 25 in a high school, in a public school building. You can go to a fitness center, but you can't be in a weight room in our school. So there's a lot of conflicting guidance, and it's really tough to weed through that. So when we get to 28, I just wanna make sure that this is a document for all of you. It's not that we don't wanna have programs. My wife would tell me every day, let's have programs. I have four kids. They usually never leave this campus. Between swimming lessons, summer rec, tennis lessons, swimming lessons, the actual swim program. So it's all under here, and we'll talk about it at the 28th. If everybody remembers last fall, late October, there was guidance that was put in that basically allows us to, we got one-time safety money, and it's the sum of like $41,000. So what we did is we spent money on Crisis Go. So that's an automated alert system that is on everyone's devices, either on a phone or a computer or a laptop. And then the other piece is that we are spending Angie, $5,600.
Yep.
And so what we're gonna do is have, these come in hard plastic. I have samples in my office, but the final product has gone to this agency, and these will be able in every room in our district. And because we have a lot of people that come into our district that are not necessarily employees, we change employees throughout the year. So if we had a lockout, which is, they don't call it a lockdown anymore, it's a lockout, a lockout, a lockdown, evacuate, shelter, hold. This is kind of the model language they're using. We'll do training on this fall, but we have to spend our one-time money by June 30th. So we've done some camera upgrades. We did the Crisis Go. We paid for some trainings for some safety stuff. So I just want you to be aware that that's one of the things that's going to see in the bills.
So we maxed out on cameras now?
The issue is, really, it's a server.
that's
the other thing we're going to
do. So that's what we're replacing.
The other one is like $18,000. Okay. Right now, you, in the back of the server stack, you can't add any more.
They suggest not to, so we went with a different system that allows you to have up to 300 cameras in it.
Okay, so
this will so be
much
well
better. Much, much better.
Perfect.
Right now, I don't care what to say, but you have no coverage on the parking lots, you have no coverage in any of our industrial tech rooms, you don't have any coverage in some of our key liability areas. And so we took the one-time money to get a new server stack so we can add new cameras. And I think you priced it all two different versions.
Yep, we're going with a different ARP system if you have it in any of your workplaces. I guess they used to have it here and it was well liked. And again, it just allows for more cameras and then we can put them where the holes are.
So that piece is going on. We'll have Crisis Go again next year. We have a training guard lined up in July with the administrative team for the new team. And we can go through that. Summer maintenance, so over at Good Elementary, there's asbestos pavement and carpet replacement in some of the key areas. They'll be moving out here. There isn't asbestos on this campus, but there are improvements being made. So you'll see that all the moves of all the different rooms. What you're gonna see is down this wing is pretty much the intermediate school. High school over here trying to segregate our 7th and 8th graders out of our senior hallway. So that's some of the maintenance that's happening over here. Out at Wynn, there's more asbestos abatement and carpet replacement. So that got taken care of and that started in the middle of May. So some teachers are already moved out. And then if you saw the pool, there's a video being made of the pool, so we can get an update. But we put all new LED lights in place of the pool. And we replaced all the grates around the edge of the pool, so it's like a massive improvement. So the videos we made of the pool before, here the next few weeks to show people all the improvements we made. Bill, anything you want to say about community ed that you want to touch on?
No, not at this point.
You just said Laker Legends has gone off, kicked off really well.
Yep, Laker Legends was here the first 2 weeks, went very, very well. It's
speed
now back.
Strength today went really well.
Yep, speed and strength went very, very well, and we'll talk about some of those other things we may go to here at the end of the meeting.
Is there anything K-12 or K-6 you want to touch on?
No. I mean, with the school year and are really working to start thinking about next year and where we're headed, some curriculum work that's happening this summer. Pretty traditional things trying to close up our year right now.
A lot of feedback to see a car floating around the board. There's a lot of positive feedback about graduation, so that went well. Corey's had his first board meeting out in Ortonville, so good luck to him. And so you have senior board report, that kind of. And then, of course, there's summer school. I mean, if you don't know, it's distance learning. So they're doing community medical telemedicine, but there is summer school happening the other way. So, subject questions kind of concludes my brief.
Questions, comments?
Sorry, I should mark anything you want to touch on. I'll collect devices, collecting back.
Went very well. Less damage than I was expecting just because the younger kids brought it home. Except, you know, just a few handful of things, but nothing like I was expecting. So, went really well.
Excellent.
Thanks, Mark.
All right, onto the consent calendar. Any new hires or resignations? Extended to student hires or staff reductions that might be pulled out for discussion? Hearing none, it's a pleasure to report.
Motion approved.
Approved by Marcus. Is there a second?
Second, a second.
Okay, for the discussion. Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed nay. Motion carries. All right, consider approval of the 2021 membership renewals in the MSBA and the Rural Education Association. Jeff?
It's just time for renewal. MRA is pretty much our spokesperson for rural Minnesota. And then I think you find it very valuable to be a member of MSBA. So we use a lot of their policy. In fact, we subscribe to their policy. So I would recommend approval.
Policy committee, you want to start making their own policies?
No, thank you.
Okay. It's a pleasure to board.
I'll make a motion to approve.
Marcus, is there a second?
I'll second.
So any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Any motion carries. Quotes for snow and soft salt.
We do this annually. I guess the only thing I can say to you is, do you want to go to a 3-year versus an annual? Right now we're doing it annually. It seems to be the same vendor every year. But
last year was a little different.
Oh yeah, it was a little different. So
because we broke up the
we did
campuses.
Right. And that was my only question. Are we, because you talked about, you know, now that our staff is using our own salt truck, are we just clarifying that more of the bids out here? How was, I mean, Corey, I know I wasn't here to answer that. I know you're talking about it, but when this bid goes out or the RFPs on it, are we talking about doing our own salting then on at least like the high school end, unless it's salt setting, unless we're going to look for a specific day that we're getting hammered because we kind of talked about
it. Angie, let's take a note and then let's do this. Let's relook our bid. We have time.
Mm-hmm.
And so let's take, I think we should just, yeah. Let's take
out. We gotta clarify that, I think, a little
I'll
bit.
I'll clarify our bid, and I'll send out to the facilities committee, and you can just take a look at it.
Mm-hmm.
We can look at it tomorrow and get a tweet.
A little bit of equipment.
The other two, it's gonna be changed too, is working, we do have a 1-ton truck. So we did have a substantial savings in snow removal last year. So I did authorize the purchase of a plow for that truck. Because there's a lot of times we could probably do quite a bit ourselves and not have to call somebody in on the tweener snow, like 4 inches. If it's, we could do some things, basically, Corey said.
So again, we should clarify, like,
yep.
It's less than 3 inches, don't come, type of thing. We just need to work through some work.
And the language of the, I know for a fact, with both vendors, they were fine, but it was just having Corey in charge now making that call when they come. So we need that clarification of Corey will notify him when it's a plow event, requires him to plow, things like that.
I'll review the bid, send it out to the facilities committee in the next 48 hours.
Right.
Okay, so look at it.
So the motion would be called for bids based upon those modifications.
Yep.
Comfortable with that? Comfortable with that, it's a pleasure to board.
Can we just move table with it?
I think we can move forward and authorize the facilities committee to adopt recommendations made with that modified proposal.
Make a motion.
Comfortable with that?
Yep, I'll make a motion for those words you just said.
Okay. Go ahead and
I'll
yes.
Second.
Okay, thank you. Yeah,
discussion? Hearing none, all in favor, say aye.
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 Motion carries. Gatsby.
So Gatsby is just, when we consolidate districts a long time ago, it just allows an evaluation, has to be done annually for our, I gotta think about it. It's not the auditor, but it basically knows how to measure, when you do the levy, how much money we should be levying for our deferred severances. So this last year, the evaluation was done and we were actually to the positive, so it was good. 2 years ago, we were to the negative, so the evaluation just has to be done. So when we approve the levy in December, it knows what that levy should be set at.
So you want to be covered for these liabilities?
I shall move that we are.
Okay, there's a second.
Right, no second.
Thank you. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Motion carries. The counter bequest has assigned funds, music money, right?
Mm-hmm. So I think what they've done is they've identified some purchases they want to make, and so it just allows you to approve those purchases on the out of your funds from our music department.
Make motion to approve. Thank you. Is there a second?
Yep.
Meyer, any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Motion carries. 2020 revised budget.
2 weeks ago, at the end of the year, you get from MD what your approved ADMs are. We built the budget on 1260. Our ADM average was 1270. There's a decimal point, but basically 1270 point something. So we adjust our budget for our actual revenue, not our projected revenue. So we made the adjustment. This is the same as the work session, so we're projecting about $140,000 to the positive under fund balance, pending our MA billing, which we did submit, which we talked about last work session. So the revised budget you're approving is on projected, well, 1260 to 1270, and that's the adjustment we approved tonight.
Question for the pleasure board.
I'll make a motion to approve.
Has there a second? Versus. We'll call Marshalls.
Yes.
Christensen's yes. Cooper.
Yep.
Meyer.
Yes.
Brayden.
Yes.
Savage.
Yes.
Motion carries. Consider approval of the 2021 budget.
So this is the same budget we just had 2 weeks ago at the work session. We also, the reductions that you took tonight, unfortunately, with our asking staff and the hiring freeze we've had this spring for any elementary positions, so the repositioning of the dean back in the classroom, now replacing all the resignations as part of this budget. So we are projecting a modest $60,000 fund balance at the end, but it is a balanced budget because the original budget was in the negative. Now, full transparency, this does not include any of the CARE Act money. So we are estimated to get up to $132,000 because I did not include this in this budget because it is not money that you have to spend. So we have an entire year. It's two different funds. It's tied to our title funds, well, our free reduced lunch. But Rick and I will work this next year, but that is not captured in here. So there are things you can charge off to, but we did not include in our budget. Because that's not what you saw 2 weeks ago. So the good news is there is some additional monies coming our way. And we'll just need to analyze. And the reason I think we should hold off, let's really see what we have in holding by the middle of September. Right now we're building a budget on 1280. We built last year on 1260, we had 1270. Let's make sure every kid comes back to the regular school. So I think we just kind of wait, but this budget gives us a baseline. It's balanced. It creates a modest fund balance increase for the adjustments.
Questions or comments? Hearing none, what's the pleasure of the board?
Make a motion to approve.
Marshalls, is there a second?
Yep.
We'll call Marshalls.
Yes.
Christensen's a yes. Cooper.
Yes.
Meyer.
Yes.
Franklin.
Yes.
Savage.
20 and 21, we're all taken care of by the personnel committee in early May. And so I would defer to you, Mr. Chair, because you sat in front of some negotiations. But for everybody that's in the public, the money that Rick and per the law, any money you're going to pay me is under the budget you would already have for paying me next year. So it's actually a reduction in your superintendent costs for next year. So I want to thank Rick for you know, working with us and sticking under the budget. Principal's contract in general is two and a little bit of increase in health insurance, which is reciprocal to what our teachers got. And then activities in community education is held flat, just because we don't really know what kind of activity we're going to have in the next 2 years, but we're competitive with our confidence.
I think everybody's pretty familiar with the negotiations, the contract, and the opportunity to review it. I think Rick, for really, negotiations was just really sitting down. Appreciate the amicable kind of resolution of all these. You all just to step up and to serve. So thank you. That being said, it's a pleasure to work.
Can we make a motion to approve items 19 through 21, or do we have to move individually?
I think you need to do one at a time.
I'll make a motion to approve item 19 then.
Okay.
Thank you, Nick. Thank you. Right,
second. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
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 Motion carries. Principal contract, talk about 202 is in health insurance and receiving negotiation.
I'll make that a motion to approve.
Okay. Is there a second?
Yes.
Nick, good job. Discussion. Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. Consider the approval of the 2020 through 2020 activities for the education director contract and some increases in salary and some compensation for the information to the health insurance. Anything else? Okay. Any further discussion related to this item? Questions? It's a pleasure to board.
Right, I'll make a motion.
Is there a second?
Second.
Meyer, for the discussion. If not, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
There's an aye. Motion carries. Talked about the athletic trainer agreement with Glacier Ridge, excuse me.
We have a 5-year extension with a flat increase, no increase. It's been a phenomenal service. And so, very blessed to have this service at no increase over 5 years.
It's nice to keep it local too. We've tried that for years, and we've been working on trying to create a partnership for over decades. Like, they stepped up. Appreciate it. Any other comments?
Just to reflect in the minutes that Director Meyer will be abstaining.
That being said, what's the pleasure of the board?
I'll make a motion to approve.
Christmas, is there a second?
Right, in the second.
Right, for discussion. Hearing none, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed nay. There's an abstention from Meyer. Motion carries.
I've learned in my days not that badly the auditor's happy.
Yeah. Transfer for Vicki and Rick for the remainder of the 2020 calendar year. Any discussion related to this will be formal?
Just remember that no board member will ever go to the bank and actually do a wire transfer, no matter what your email says. And even if it says from me or from Rick or from Vicki, that's just something board members will never actually have to do.
Yeah, well, that's
they tried it. A couple years ago, they tried to transfer $87,000 to a bank. I'm sure it was going to overseas, just getting routed to Kentucky.
Yes.
All right, motion to approve that.
Thank you, Jan. Second?
Yep.
Nick, further discussion? Say aye. Spark 27, we have a contract for 21.
So anybody knows, this last year was very busy with Spark 27. We put a flat fee, which would be a reduction of $8,000, which we spent last year. It's included in the budget you approved tonight. But it allows for website maintenance, so our website. It allows for any, it'll give us some assistance in our newsletter. So I think we're going to do our newsletter the first week of August. So we
job, Angie.
No, okay, Spark 27.
Well, I think it's Angie. Do you want to say anywhere? Angie's doing the key.
Well, thank you.
All right, any questions? It's a pleasure, board.
Any motion to approve?
Aye.
Go ahead, Dan. I'll second it.
Marcus. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor, say aye.
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 So may motion carries. Second reading, we've all had an opportunity to review the student handbook. Both fourth reading. Any questions or comments? Hearing none, it's a pleasure, board.
Great, then I'll make a motion.
I'll second.
Second by Meyer. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Motion carries. Second reading of the staff, support staff handbook. We'll have an opportunity to move through that. Any questions or comments? Hearing none, it's a pleasure, board.
Motion to approve.
Okay. Whisper, is there a second?
Reichman will second.
Reichman, second. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor, say aye.
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 Motion carries. Second reading of the following policies. We've had an opportunity to review all those, and one that will have to be reviewed and discussed. Hearing none, it's a pleasure, board.
Make a motion to approve.
Marcus, is there a second?
I'll second.
Meyer. Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor, say aye.
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 Nay. Motion carries. Talk about school facilities opening.
Okay, so Mr. Chair, members of the board, the community, again, I think I take full responsibility for maybe not clearly communicating what happened. So May 31st came around on Friday. We had a Region 6A meeting, I think on Thursday the 30th. At the time, it was very unclear. There was a lot of, back and forth about, I don't think we should do anything. We should, I personally thought we could do something. And so what I proposed is, like, we had all the coaches come in the media center here. We met, and, at the time, it was, they didn't think we could do anything. And I think that we couldn't do anything the way we've been doing in the past. So we discussed what we could do. We knew we needed to do Laker Legends just because we already knew the need was great, right? And there's a part of NDA that says we need to provide some school-age care. So we found a mechanism to do that. At the time, when we brought all our coaches in, it was unclear how you would separate cohorts. Well, I don't know, my son's in speed and strength, so I saw an email that went out, like, there might be 8-9 cohorts of speed and strength. And our concern is those cohorts cannot intermix. So Max Reichman and Nate Rankin are in the same cohort right now at 6 o'clock in the morning. But if Max decides to go play basketball with cohort 4, then both cohorts are eliminated. So the question is, when you open this up, how are we going to do that? Right? Because you can't intermingle.
So my clarification question on that, and that's some of the questions I've been getting from people, is that if that second event is a school-run event, or it's on school property, regardless of who's running it, say the basketball association is putting on a 7-on-7 camp in the afternoon, but not our high school coaches doing it, but they're just using our facility. Is that the same thing? It's not. So,
and as far as the intermingling is concerned, obviously strength and speed, there's no intermingling. You've got the 9 pods, the 9 cohorts, you know, yeah. In talking to Megan, and she did some checking with the Department of Health as well, now that we're in this June 15 time period, and there are schools obviously that have started today and some have started later, if you have an athlete that's a multi-sport athlete, say take a Boyer drill, for example, that's in football, basketball, baseball, whatever it is, and they have a summer practice, it's impossible to think you're not going to have to intermix at some level. But that intermixing across multiple sports needs to be kept at a minimum. So if you can keep those kids as many as possible in their strength and speed pods, if they're in a basketball, whenever it starts, whether it's now or whether it's July 6th or whatever it is, you need to still keep that at a minimum. And when they're in those groups, in specific sports, they can't intermix either. They have to stay. So that would be the only intermixing there would be. There can't be, they just can't. It's not going to be perfect as long as you've got kids that are multi-sport athletes.
So when we came on the 31st, the guidance at the time was, that was before the before, which usually, you know, runs these programs, already being upside down, we didn't want to go further upside down, right? Because, I mean, we don't know where this thing's going to end when it comes to money. So, you know, typically we've had two or three coaches run speed and strength for everybody, and then we pay those coaches. Now we have, you know, the question was, now we're going to probably 10, 12 coaches, because you're going to have to run three or four different courts at the same time in different areas. And you can't be in the weight room. You kind of got to be outside. So I'm like, well, how are you going to do that? And we're going to have enough kids to even do it. So, and also, we haven't had kids in here for 9 weeks, so we want to make sure we retrain our kids. Like, if you come on school property, like, and I think what I would say is that everybody has a different idea about, I've been to an art inside, been to a restaurant, right? And it's all different. But the problem is, as soon as you come on school property, we're governed by a whole other set of rules. And so at the time, we said, well, we'll do speed and strength. We'll start that June 15th. And then we can add other activities as it happens. Well, then you fast forward 4 days later, we have a board work session, I remote in, and it's just like, we weren't prepared to open the door to all the activities yet, because we didn't even figure out speed and strength yet. They were gonna meet on Wednesday after the work session. They met again to get all the registration information out. And so I wanted to make sure that we were careful. And so, well, what we're prepared to do tonight is, you know, if we have a coach or advisor who can look through these, and like, for me, okay, so I'm a wrestling coach. The Minnesota Wrestling Coaches Association, USA Wrestling, there's all these, you know, programs that you belong to that figure out this for you. So if there's a way we can go through these guidelines and offer dance, and our dance coach can meet these guidelines and offer a program, then I would recommend that we allow kids to register the community ed, and we can offer those things. It's just that we weren't prepared, you know, 2 weeks before we opened up to do it. And I think that, and also, there's been another governor's, you know, directive come out. So changes are happening all the time. I guess the heart and soul, so does anybody have an issue if we, if our coaches come up with protocols that, that are in line with this, are you okay with that? I'm okay with it.
I personally agree with that.
No. The issue is that it's one attendant. So you can't have 26 people doing, no matter if you're 6 feet apart. Correct, Bill?
Correct.
One and nine.
I'm in favor of that too. I don't have a problem with that at all. But like I said, that was kind of the crux of my question earlier, trying to clarify that again. I think I was being explaining it correctly. So what I'm talking about is that mess, we get our coaches to do that, okay? But then now are we opening it up to baseball association that needs bigger fields right now that doesn't play on varsity?
That's the next thing we're going to talk about.
Okay, that's what I'm trying to get clarification.
That would be different.
So the next one, I've had 3 people reach out to me. So, and I talked to Rick, call 4 ADs, and obviously I'm trying to find a way we can play baseball. All right, so I know that there's a Stars game scheduled for like the 26th of June. And I don't know of any way right now on school property that you're authorized to play a competitive baseball game. I want people to play, but right now, I don't think, and Bill, correct me if I'm wrong, but I don't think there's any way. Now, I did one piece that was shared with me is, okay, well, Stars are not, they're amateur. They don't have anything to say high school. So then the question is, comes to you as a board, who do you want to authorize on your property? Who do you want not want to authorize on your property? So, like, you know, obviously, you watched WCCO the other day. Stearns County decided to let amateur baseball play in Stearns County. That would be, we would be, in my opinion, a direct violation of the governor's directive to allow a competitive baseball game to play on our property, regardless of how you personally feel about it. I don't know all that you're allowed to with the current executive order. Is that a true statement, Bill?
That's a true statement.
So that's kind of where we're at. That's the crossroads we're at, right? We can offer, girls can go dance, 1 to 9. You could probably go play tennis, 1 to 9. You could probably do baseball activities out there in different pods. Softball activities, different pods. You could probably be on the track, different pods, right? But when you're gonna have a competitive baseball game, they just don't offer it yet. Right? The baseball game, you're not allowing the weight rooms yet, correct? I don't think you're, it's great.
Well, you can, but we're not at a point where there's been too few kids that would be allowed in there to get any, make any headway in there. So that could change, like you said. Playing baseball games could change. And the governor there has been talking.
back up to the discussion of the Stearns County League, basically. So they are going ahead, you just said?
They're playing, but they're not playing on school property. They're playing on amateur baseball fields in small communities.
Right, so that would be public property. Who owns it? I mean, the city?
City.
So I guess what I'm asking is, what's really the difference if it's a public entity, whether it be a school or a city, you know, when it comes to a virus? You know what I mean? Why would it be okay for the, and it's, I'm just asking the question.
I think it's a great overarching question. The reality is that we're inclined to follow many more different entities than I think the city of New Munich. We've got the Department of Ed, we've got the high school to give us directives, we've got the Department of Health, I'm missing some.
Well, you have the National Federation of
State High School Leagues. So we have how many entities that are giving us certain outlines? They're not all the same, of course.
Well, the challenge me too with the Stars is that there are a certain number of high school kids that do play that are still governed in the state high school league. So,
have the Stars asked to play games? Is that
I'm not gonna text them.
But we're not talking. It's not gonna be our Minnewaska team. It'd be the Stars, and I get it. There's crossover. Same thing with those kids. They're going to wherever Melrose or wherever they're from. You know, so it just boils down to who owns the field of yes or no at this point. And I guess I have a lot of trouble with that. You know, I believe the St. Paul Saints are going to start playing in Sioux Falls, right? Like, it was in the Star Tribune, I guess.
I know you can go play in Fargo.
I think it would be extremely helpful that there would be more consistency from the top, because we're all spinning our wheels down here to a certain extent. We could say one way or the other and argue for 2 days on it, and it doesn't really matter, you know. But I guess if there is a mechanism for sending a message upstream that if it's okay to play on the New Munich City, the municipal field, I could only assume, you know, I don't know, maybe it isn't. Maybe it is just some guy's field that he lets them play on. But, you know, what's the difference, you know? So there isn't such disappointment when it comes to a scenario like this. Because that's what I think what people really get cranked up about is if it's a perceived unfairness. You know, why can you play in Fargo but not here? Can't play in Moorhead, but you can get across the river and you can play. That's, you know, what really makes people cranked up.
I don't disagree, Ted, but like I don't think a school district can fix that problem for everybody is the problem. I don't disagree with you at all. We were talking about the golf before I started here. So right. If I go to Eagle Creek today, PGA Association of Minnesota says I can't watch my kid golf today, even though I could have played with them in a foursome. I drove into Wilmer. Could have had my whole family out golfing there 2 hours later. If Eagle Creek Golf Course is designed today in Kanyohai County, says, no, screw this. I don't care what the governor says. I don't care what the PGA Association of Minnesota says. They allow spectators. I don't know if they ever get fined by the PGA or they just never get a tournament there again. And so the tournament, they get upset. But it wasn't Eagle Creek's decision. They're just following the protocols the PGA event said to do that day. We can't make, as much as I agree with you, and it doesn't make sense, I don't see it. We can, if the governor says, or if there's a mandate right now that you can't have competitive baseball games, it's just that it's easy. We can't do it. If we can allow practices, if we can allow things through certain protocols that we're allowed to do it at this point, we can. Not that I agree with any of it, but why Minnewaska School District shouldn't be the ones that just says, no, sorry, Governor Waltz, you're wrong. I agree with you. I just don't think we can make that decision.
I'm not saying that we're saying he is wrong. I guess I just like an explanation of why is it okay for a municipal, and I'm only assuming that. I don't exactly know if that's a city baseball field. See what I'm asking? If it isn't, if it's just some guy's field of dreams field, I get it. They can go play, right?
Even if the city, they might just, it's probably not okay for the governor, but they're probably just doing it.
Right.
It could be. But I guess some explanation of why, you know, it is, why we're different than Wisconsin, why we're different than Iowa.
Politics.
South Dakota. Well, I mean, just say that then. If that's what it is, just send the letter back saying that's what it is. That's all I'm asking. And I'm not telling him he's wrong. He's the governor. He can do what he wants. But, you know, as we can see, there needs to maybe be some questions asked.
I think the tricky part about all this is why, you know, it kind of caught us off guard because here it is May 29th, we find out you can open in 2 weeks. But 110, 120 miles between us, we're all over the place because nobody really knows all those 59 pages of guidance. So what can you, can't you do? And everybody wants to do something, right? I mean, everyone's busted the seams. My wife would love to drop our kids off and go to swim lessons. They should love to go back and play a softball behind here. And we'd love to have kids up here. Just that, you know, for me, I'm just honestly saying, right now, as your superintendent, can tell you, I advocate that you can allow competitive baseball. Do I think there's a huge issue in having it? Nobody cares what I think. As a superintendent in a board session, I would recommend you don't authorize it right now. Now, the governor might come out tomorrow, because nobody knows his schedule, and say, I authorize competitive baseball. The second he authorizes it, then I recommend you authorize competitive baseball up here. Until then, I think, unfortunately, you might have to go to the new Munich, because they're letting you in, but right now, federal and state funds will fund this place, you know, off local taxpayers. Rick, anything you'd add?
Just a comment. What Ted's talking about down in the southern part of the state, the schools that border the Iowa border and the western border are serving notice to the legislature and the governor that in Iowa they're allowing all these activities. And so the message I've heard is, you know, either get it figured out by the fall or we're going to open and enroll our kids to an Iowa school where they're not as restricted. I don't know if it's right or wrong, but that's, I think there is feedback going to the governor regularly, and I think that's why every couple weeks there is a new executive order that comes out that's more or less restrictive. So I think that everything you're talking about is actually happening, but it's, you know, they're responding in a measured way.
And the reality is, we had our special session on June 3rd, right? And what happened a couple days later?
Yeah, executive order comes out.
We had modifications to the executive order where we could open things up again.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, one of the things I think we consider is that we're going to have to allow things to open. We're also going to have to allow our staff or our administration team to recognize it might go both ways. We don't know. I don't know. I don't know.
Right.
I do have a letter from Mr. Holtberg that pertains to this, that he can't be here tonight, so if you wanted me to read it, if that's okay, Mr. Chair.
Sure.
Sorry, not available tonight as I'm at Lake of the Woods and I have bed cell service. As many of you know, I've been very passionate about opening our facilities under the guidelines of the Minnesota Department of Health, Minnesota Department of Education, Minnesota State High School League. Some of you might think this is self-serving, but I've already come to realize that my son will get 3-4 weeks of baseball, so I'm over that outbreak. I have been contacted by multiple parents for athletes in dance, tennis, basketball, baseball, cross country, track, and volleyball. Many parents of female athletes in particular have said that their children don't like the strength and speed program as it caters to the male athletes. We only allow for the strength and speed program that keeps athletes from doing anything else with the intermingling guidelines. I asked Chairman Christensen to add the opening of the facilities to the agenda to tonight's meeting. I was told we didn't need to make it an action item. I had a great conversation with Mr. Rankin on Wednesday night, and I said I would be back. I said I would back off, but since that conversation, I've been asked by many more times why we are only open facilities for speed and strength. Because of these people, I feel the need to weigh in tonight. All the states around us are open. Iowa started their full high school spring season today. Opening our facilities according to state guidelines and putting trust in our coaches is the right thing to do. The coaches have worked hard putting together plans that meet the state guidelines. As long as we follow the guidelines, we have no liability issues. This is bigger than just our facilities and sports. When given permission to open, we must do our part to help the school and community come back to life. It is important for mental well-being of these kids. In closing, I want to remind everyone
far, the only voices I'm hearing are in favor of opening our facilities. This not being an action item, I support the opening of the facilities starting tomorrow, June 16th. Thanks, everyone in the chat.
I guess I would just say in response to that, the people have emailed me, all four of you, and when I cancel or delay school, it goes to 2,950 emails. Well, I am very sensitive to this. I have kids too. And you know what? We want to open up. But you gotta realize we sit here on May 30th and we got registered the following week without meeting to get your. We are following these guidelines. These guidelines change with every executive order. And so it's hard to stay on top of it. And we as superintendents don't get notified when the changes are coming. And yes, I realize that we want to open things up and we're going to have to really rely on our coaches because they're the ones who are going to have to be out there doing mitigation. So I don't have a problem with opening certain things up, but there's certain things that won't open up. I mean, yeah, great. We have wrestling? Nope. Not even going to go down the path. Well, you know, I feel bad. And so the difficulty is when you get all these rules and the co-mingling, it's not an easy thing to figure out. There are some people just getting buttoned up all summer and not even have a discussion. So I would say my recommendation is if our coaches can go through the facility use check-in, they can go through the COVID procedures, if they can mitigate their program and do something that's 1-9, and it makes sense for their program to bring it forward for approval by our activities director. If he approves it, and it comes in tomorrow and they want to start Wednesday, have at it, register with the community yet so we're protected liability-wise, and we open up. But like at this time, I don't know any way that we are allowed to have like certain things are just non-negotiable. Right now, competitive baseball, competitive softball will be one of them. It's just not, it's unfortunate. Now, do we have kids that play for the Stars and they go play, you know, over in, I don't even know what that little town is between us and Painesville, that you know, Regal.
Regal.
If they can go play at Regal, then that's not our problem, right? Now, but we also have to be careful, and that's why I said the last work session, but there are a lot of rules for our coaches. I mean, you're still governed by the Minnesota State High School League. And even though you may have a waiver, this opens some waivers, but you know, we have to be very careful that our coaches don't do something that would get them in trouble because they decide that, you know what, I want to have competitive baseball, so I'll go coach my JV team over in the Regal Field. That would pose a problem. So like that's why we're not open to the full aperture. It's not that I don't love baseball, softball, and all this. It's just like I love wrestling too, but we're not doing that. And so I think right now, I'd go back to what the board chair said. We'll open the door to what makes sense. We'll run it through our AD to be supervised. There are certain things that, you know what, tomorrow the governor comes and lets us do it, we'll be responsive. We'll run it through our activities director. And if we can do it, because we don't have our next meeting until July 20th, if the executive order comes out on Wednesday and allows competitive baseball, and we're ready to go, we can do it on Thursday. And we, for everybody who's watching this or is going to listen, we want you to be out here. I mean, we are in the business of child mental health. And I don't need to be told that. I'm a licensed teacher. I'm a head coach. I know the very well meaning of keeping a well-balanced kid. I'm also a father of four kids. And so I want to open everything we can responsibly. So I think it's not an action item, but are we okay with that?
Could the same be said just to getting off the athletic and activity front for a second? Community education, same except for those programs, start under proper protocol, which I don't see starting before July 6th.
So we're trying to figure out, could we have summer rec in the month of
right.
July? No. The challenge, though, for everybody at the board, is it has unintended consequences. So if you have 100 kids, where we used to have 4 employees, you might need 10. Now you can pay those 10 employees $14 an hour. Maybe you can't charge $50. Maybe you have to charge $100 and they get 3 weeks of less service. So then you have free reduced lunch kids that maybe can't qualify. So people want to make this a very simple equation. We don't want to open up. There are unintended consequences.
Can't we send an email out to say, this is what we're weighing, we need to gauge interest for the possibility of opening up community yet?
Well, we could just put a registration based on what we're talking about here.
And be
getting people to register.
And be very transparent with the registration, say it's going to cost more because of staff.
Right. Or, well, no. I mean, we've worked on that because we would work that in, concert with Laker Legends, that group would come out here and that staff would help us staff the morning program, which would cost us a whole lot less because they're already.
Because I think you do will have a certain amount that have already written it off, and then they'll just, you get it getting into July when you're going to have it, and you're like, well, if we're working remote and we're going to, we aren't going to take our kids up to that anyway. So it may not be as high a number as we think.
Yep,
so,
may not. And then we might have to, if it isn't going to go, we'll just refund everybody who registered just like we did in the spring. That's very simple. That's how we do it. We propose it.
Yes,
we
I
get
know,
it out this
I know parents are, you know, like Chip said, we've all kind of wasted. It's, my kid's playing baseball again this year, just a lot of stuff to do. So you do it. Their parents would love options for the kids to do right now, even if they are at home with them, just to go get some interaction if they can do it safely.
Personally, I'd be cautious to send out that, you know, kind of, if I'm understanding correctly, kind of a who's interested letter at this point, because it does change so quick. If there is maybe a middle ground, maybe I'm all wet, but maybe we just send a letter. Send the letter up the stream, kind of like you were saying the guys are doing on the southern border. Basically, hey, here's what we're seeing in our community. We're having some pushback. There is still concern. You know, what are we missing, or how are we different than these other states? Because with those answers coming from the top, and he has the total decision. I get it. He's right. I mean, he's the one that gets to make it. But then, does that kind of push the envelope a little bit for the people that want everything wide open? Does that kind of get everything just kind of moving forward a little bit so we are doing something? We aren't just sitting here going, open it all up, willy-nilly. We aren't saying lock it all down, we aren't doing a thing. Is that putting an oar in the water? Is that something that is workable? Because like you say, it might be a weekend, everything click, light switch goes. We don't know. Or it could go the other way. There could be a flood of stuff going and it's locked down and everybody goes, whoa, what just happened?
Well, the big thing too, we set this up originally, is just the overhead on screening everybody walking in, temperature scanning everybody, you know, doing the screening. It just is a little cumbersome. So that's why we weren't prepared to have 250 kids float around our campus, you know, today, because we weren't really prepared for that. You know, we did buy some thermometers, but we bought PPE for our staff, right? We didn't buy, if you're not a current staff member, we don't have a stockpile of PPE. You know, and our custodians are really focused on, you know, asbestos abatement, so they're not in here to clean up after you everywhere you go. So what I would propose is do exactly what you did, Ted. We can draft that and send it. I think Bill goes ahead and works with Heidi to get something ready for, you know, maybe early next week to just registration pending enrollment numbers. And then we start July 6th after the 4th of July weekend. And maybe this year we only have 30 kids. And then, you know, but on the flip side, we also have to gauge our staff, right? Because we can't hire 5 people until we know our kids. But, you know, time is ticking. If we don't get going on it, we can try something. So I think we do both. I think we... You work with Heidi and get registration. Maybe we keep the price the same because it's condensed, it's not as much. And then we gauge our participation. Because I know a lot of it, there are high school kids that really, really want to do this. I mean, they this is their summer job. And I mean, we can find some employees. It's not a lot of overhead. And it might be, you know, and I think too, like, we do provide service to our community.
I mean, even if we lose money on it, at least we're gaining mental health. Of these kids locked down all summer. I mean, everything can't be positive cash flow.
I don't think any board member here, no, one single board member that I've worked with, ever argued that we don't want activities. We don't want a broad range of activities.
Right.
We want all of our kids to be involved. Both of my kids were 3 sport athletes involved in various activities. We encourage that. So I want to make sure that the community understands that. We want opportunities, and we're also going to be smart and responsible because we have also a responsibility to the district as a whole, safety-wise. I think we're all on the same page.
So what we'll do is we'll send a message to all of our coaches and advisors tomorrow morning. We'll explain these protocols. If they can come back and they want to make a presentation to Bill, and it meets the benchmark, Bill, I just ask every Friday to provide an update to me that I can send them to the board of my board report. So comment that everybody who's listening to this, when you want to take this on, and I appreciate everyone of our coaches doing this, that you just have to strictly follow the protocol, regardless of how you feel about COVID, this is what you're signing up for. And we have to retrain our kids. I said that before too. You know, it's hard to retrain a second grader who wants to go see her friends. She hasn't seen for like 10 weeks because, you know, they're the ranking kids. They live all on 10 acres and they're not allowed to leave home. You know, then they're going to want to come in and hug and do all these things. And well, I don't care. It's like, you know, now you're on the clock and moms and dads trust them that you're doing the right thing. So we'll do that and we'll get a report to you here in the next 2 weeks. And for every community member, trust me, we want your kids here. Just like the board chair said, we want to have activities. We're just going cautiously because we don't want to. We take the safety of your kids the very first thing we consider when you come on, and our staff. So, any questions or if we're good? Billy, you got enough guidance to go off of?
Mm-hmm. All set.
Justin, you got anything? Good.
All right. Look at the
announcements. No, I think you got it covered.
Yeah, thank you, Justin. With that being said, please modify the July rate.